Good afternoon again.
Hello.
Dear Quantum Technology Community, and thank you for the organization of this great event. Warm welcome to everybody. My name is Olga Strovasnin. Thank you, Konstantin. I'm working in the headquarters of Laser Components in Germany. As you can see in our company's name, our main focus is on components for laser technology and photonics, including components used in the industry, but also in research and development. We develop and produce the components needed in the market ourselves. For the quantum applications, those are not huge ground or satellite systems, but our single photon count modules are a part of it. Let me first explain our motivation to join this impressive event. We understand the quantum applications as the future for the technology, communication, and information flow. Already since years, many of tele and internet communication companies, computer giants such as IBM, Google, Facebook, are working on quantum computers, which bring us forward to faster data processing for any purpose. This great technology, however, can be also misused for cracking the security codes and for eavesdropping. The future communication is unthinkable without a safe and resistant information flow. The quantum communication, in particular the quantum key distribution, should counteract and withstand eavesdropping attacks. There are already maintained a huge number of European, Russian, but also Northern American and Asian projects to support the research and development of the quantum communication interface. For example, a program named Quantum Flagship started in January 2020 and should last for 10 years. We live now in a quantum decade. But I believe quantum is not limited to 10 years. It will accompany our life and work in future. What is QKD? Just a small excursion, even though I think everyone here is more than familiar with it. Alice sends a message to Bob, coded with photons in horizontal, vertical, diagonal, and anti-diagonal quantum states. Bob is using two detectors aligned for the horizontal, vertical, or diagonal, anti-diagonal. After receiving the key from Alice, he can compare his detected bits and finally decode the message. This information flow is not only very fast, but also immune to eavesdropping. Any third-party intervention disturbs the quantum states of the photons, but does not receive any information without the key. One important component in the quantum communication system are the single photon detectors. What technology is usable for it? Let's start with the very beginning. What is the very low light level? Usually we use watts for optical power. It means milliwatt, microwatt, but those are not yet low light level. Nanowatt looks already better. But at the real very low light level, we are only there with picowatt. It means at 10 to the minus 12 or 10 to the minus 15 and less. It corresponds to 100 kilocounts per second and less. In this graph, you can see how the number of photons corresponds to the optical power. How do we come in our detector from the linear mode, which means in picowatt, to the counting mode for a real single photon counter? An avalanche photodiode converts the photons of incoming light into the electrical current as every other semiconductor photodiode. The avalanche effect amplifies this current already inside the semiconductor chip, depending on the operating voltage, also called reverse bias voltage. The multiplication gain up to 250 is possible. We speak here about more than 100 volts, maybe several hundred watts. The detected current is still proportional to the incoming optical power and very usable at low light level. However, at a certain point at a breakdown voltage, the electrical breakdown occurs, as you can see in the second graph. Again, above the breakdown voltage is up to 10 to the 8th. Or with other words, each incidence on the active area creates a breakdown. Spots that operate at this high gain regime I sometimes refer to being in Geiger mode. This mode is particularly useful for single photon detection. Special semiconductors are necessary then. In the case of single photon counting, you will need to keep the duck count rate low and after passing probability sufficient, no, even lower. Finally, we are there at a very low light level. Each incident photon creates an electric breakdown. By counting these events, we can detect single photons. In the case of electrical breakdown, the photodetector needs to have its signal current limited and quickly diminished. Active and passive current quenching techniques have been used for this purpose. The passive quenching circuit is electrically much easier to develop and uses usually spots with a slightly higher duck count rate of more than 100,000 hertz. One will, however, need to live with a low recovery where that time is not clearly defined. For this purpose, a single photon avalanche diode with a 500 micron diameter of active area is sufficient. A cooling with one stage or two stage TE establishes the duck count rate at a quite low level, as I mentioned before, below 1,000 hertz. The active quenching circuit brings the reverse bias voltage temporarily below the breakdown, as the name says, actively. It allows fast recovery and well-defined dead time. Here, smaller active area and a special semiconductor device are required. Those special semiconductor chips are used in our count modules. So what is the speciality of them? To detect single photons, we need really very low duck count rate. In case of our counts, even below 10 hertz is possible. The active area is smaller than this of APDs used for passive quenching, but still quite high with 100 microns. Sometimes the spans are compared with photomultipliers. This comparison is not really true because the detection efficiency is incomparable high with more than 75% at peak wavelength. What you can see for the red version in this table. We also offer blue and NIR adapted detectors and additional timing version with a shorter jitter. The whole module is completely made at laser components. The hard chip, the APD, is produced at laser components detector group in Arizona. And the module, it means the electric board, assembly of the module, and final tests are done in Germany. In the facility in Germany, we have a new test setup since few months. You can imagine that the measurements of this unique semiconductor technology are also challenging. So the new test setup measures at four different wavelengths, six free space and five fiber coupled modules simultaneously and automatically. Recently, we have also got a confirmation of our test results from PTV, a German National Metrology Institute, whose test results have been showing almost identical values. With this setup, we could establish a new testing standard of single photon counting modules. At the end, I would like to summarize the core features. A very low duck count rate, high detector efficiency, low after pulsing. Our whole production chain is one hand in our facilities in the US and Europe, so we keep the safety stock. Although it is not always possible because there are a high number of different module types and very dynamic stock situation. So thank you for listening. And for more details, you can always contact our partners at ETM. Vladimir.
Thank you very much, Olga. So I know personally that we work with these devices, and they sometimes they work perfectly.
hopefully not only sometimes. Okay. Constantine, I know that you're working with it.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thanks to a very tight contact with Vladimir.
Okay. Any questions? Okay.
Yes, thank you for your talk very much. Are SNSPDs used in QKD, and is there some advantages of your detectors from it? Because we've been told that this is the best detector for single photons.
Yeah, of course, every manufacturer said that it's the best. So yes, our detectors are used in QKD already in several laboratories. So we sell our detectors for in Europe, in Northern America, in Asia, in Russia. Advantages, I try to emphasize a few of them. So the very low dark current rate, we have the possibility to calm down even below 10 hertz, 10 dark counts per second. We have very high detection efficiency for the red, for the typical silicon sensitivity with more than 75% typically.
Okay, yeah.
Any
sure.
Specific specifications you are looking for?
I can add that some of your devices, I believe the 300 micron EP disk have been quite extensively tested for QKD applications. Those are silicon devices, so they are useful for satellite links, free space links. They have been radiation tested. And I believe they are used in this quantum satellite built by Singapore. Are they? We also tested some of them for radiation damage.
I'm not sure I'm allowed.
Well, this is all published. You can find papers that have tested SAP 300, I believe, have been tested for radiation and for use on satellites.
Yes, exactly. You mentioned the specific name we called SAP 300 or 500. Those APDs, as I mentioned before, are more useful for passive quenching with a bigger active area. So in our count modules, we use a special type, which we do not sell separately. We call it SAV. And they are a bit smaller. Actually, the active area is around 300 microns, but we recommend to use 140 to 100 central portion.
Okay, thank you. So if, okay, one more question.
Do you have solution for C-band, 15 nanometers fiber?
Yeah, very good question. Actually, as a normal APD, not Geiger mode, we offer indium gallium arsenide APDs, but not yet Geiger mode version. I know that my colleagues in Arizona are working on it, but I cannot promise the fast results.
Okay, I think there is no question more. Olga, thank you very much once
again. Thank you again for your time and for inviting
me. Bye-bye.